Here it is difficult to suppose the reasoner in earnest. Had Monsieur Beauvais, in his search for the body of Marie, discovered a corpse corresponding in general size and appearance to the missing girl, he would have been warranted, without reference to the question of habiliment at all, in forming an opinion that his search had been successful. If, in addition to the point of general size and contour, he had found upon the arm a peculiar hairy appearance, which he had observed upon the living Marie, his opinion might have been justly strengthened, and the increase of positiveness might well have been in the ratio of the peculiarity or unusualness of the hairy mark. If, the feet of Marie being small, those of the corpse were also small, the increase of the probability that the body was that of Marie would not be an increase in the ratio merely arithmetical, but in one highly geometrical or accumulative. Add to all this shoes such as she had been known to wear upon the day of her disappearance, and although these shoes may be sold in packages, you so far augment the probability as to verge upon the certain. What, of itself, would be no evidence of identity, becomes through its corroborative position proof most sure. Give us, then, flowers in the hat corresponding to those worn by the missing girl, and we seek for nothing farther. If only one flower, we seek for nothing farther. What then if two or three or more? Each successive one is multiple evidence, proof not added to proof, but multiplied by hundreds or thousands.